Pardon?
Where do you want me to look?
At me, or the camera.
This eye, or this eye?
That eye.
At the camera, or in between the cameras?
Either way works.
All right. Are you going to ask the questions, or I just talk?
I'm sure you know better what you want the public to know than I do, but if I think of a question, I'll throw it in.
So what's this for and how long will it hold for?
Public access TV, and I'll work it in, if depending on how much info you give me, I'll work it in with interviews I do when I walk around. I do half-hour shows, but I can do as many as I have time for.
Realizing when every day that you go to the store or walk the aisles of the supermarkets, you're looking at hundreds of thousands of products made from genetically modified ingredients. That is only 8 genetically modified food products. They include soy, corn, nuts, oil, canola oil, sugar from sugar beets. These 5 are, I would say, 70% of the products in soy. Now, why is it important to know which products are genetically modified? Well, if you listen to the American Academy of Environmental Medicine, they say that every doctor in America should prescribe non-GMO diets for everyone. They point out that genetically modified foods, when fed to animals in laboratories, have shown reproductive problems, immune system problems, accelerated aging, dysfunctional regulation, cholesterol, insulin, organ damage, gastrointestinal disorders, to name a few. Let's take a look at reproductive problems. If you happen to be an unfortunate rodent fed genetically modified soy in various experiments, you may end up with damaged testicles. Testicles that change from pink to blue, changes in the ovaries and uterus, the DNA of the offspring functions differently at the embryo stage. Babies were smaller, babies died at 5 times the rate, and by the third generation, most lost the ability to have babies, some had hair growing in their mouths. These are astounding results, but you won't hear them from mainstream TV and mainstream media, because they largely and closely not the subject of the health foods of genetically modified foods. That's why it's important to educate yourself about these dangers, so you can choose healthy choices, as recommended by the American Academy of Environmental Medicine. Now, how do you choose non-GMO foods? Go to non-GMOshoppingguide.com. Non-GMOshoppingguide.com. You can download a free non-GMO shopping guide. Categories and see thousands of products that are not too low. And you can learn about some of the health dangers and why it's important to avoid GMOs. Now you might ask, how is it that our government, with the Food and Drug Administration, how could they allow such dangerous foods on the market? Well, the answer is this. If you find it, let's say, interested in being money. The policy of the FDA showing that these foods, these GM foods, are safe. On that basis, they say absolutely no testing is necessary. No labeling is necessary. You don't even have to tell the FDA if you want to put a GMO on the market. So companies like Monsanto, which is the largest GM food crop producer, they're the company that told us that Agent Orange was safe, DDT was safe, PCBs were safe. All lies. They've been fined, convicted, fined $700 million just for the PCB lies. They're in charge of determining whether their genetically modified foods are safe. Now, why is it that the FDA gave Monsanto an opportunity to determine if the foods are safe? Well, the person in charge of policy of the FDA was Monsanto's former attorney, later Monsanto's vice president, now the U.S. Food Safety Czar. And the sentence in the policy, which claimed that the agency was unaware of information showing that GMOs were different, was a lie. 44,000 secret internal memos made public in the lawsuit from the FDA's own files shows that genetically modified foods are unsafe. Superiors to require a long-term study or ignore them. Now, 20 years later, evidence shows the concerns were validated, scientists were vindicated, but we are all of a sudden in the situation. list out, denied tenure, denied funding, denied access to GM seeds. The scientists in Russia, for example, who tested the GM soy on the rats, more than half of the rats, babies, died within 3 weeks. She was told that her boss was under pressure from his boss to do no more genetically modified research. In fact, papers were burned on her desk as a method of intimidation, samples were stolen from the laboratory, and typical, but very unfortunate. We have a situation now where we have biotech companies using tobacco science, which is largely green to avoid finding problems, supported by a largely ignorant government that thinks GMOs are the same, or are the same, feeding it to humans, and we're now seeing, since GMOs were introduced in the mid-90s, an upsurge of very serious diseases, which could easily be promoted because of the genetically modified foods. So it's our job to individually, on our own, study the problems and make healthier choices. To learn about the problems, go to responsibletechnology.org. Responsibletechnology.org. And watch free videos online like Get Dangerous in Kids' Needles, because kids are most at risk. Or the video, Everything You Have to Know About Dangerous to Genetically Modified Foods. Or the milk, because from cows to the bovine growth hormone, which increases pus to milk, and antibiotics, the bovine growth hormone, and IGF-1, which is linked to cancer. You can find that in a video called Your Milk on Drugs, Just Say No. You can listen to audios, read articles, you can join the Tipping Point Network, where you can help with the outreach, bring this important crucial information to others, to create a tipping point of consumer rejection, to force GMOs out of the market. This happened in Europe. Within a single week, virtually every major food company committed to stop using GM ingredients. That was when the tipping point was achieved. That happened with a single food safety scandal caused 750 articles to be printed in Europe. 750 articles within a month. Naturally, the tipping point of consumer rejection, which forced GMOs out of the market. Same way, parents learning about the health dangers of bovine growth hormone, they've been kicking out the bovine growth hormone from most American dairies. It was kicked out of Walmart's milk, Starbucks, that. Most American dairies. So we now have a plan to engineer a tipping point against genetically engineered foods. Go to responsibletechnology.org to sign up for the Tipping Point Network. Be sure to sign up for the free electronic newsletter to keep you informed about the health dangers so that you can help protect yourself and your family. The key is this. The government is not protecting us. We have to do it ourselves. But right now, there are millions of people